ability to analyse and interpret big data, not only in the biomedical sciences, but in the world at large, has become increasingly central to the way that we operate. In bioinformatics, I think it's safe to say that really nobody in the molecular life sciences can do biology without having to analyse large data sets now. And to fulfil the need for training in this field, a community of bioinformatics trainers has coalesced over recent years. There's a lot more training available for researchers than there has ever been before. But we now have this needle in a haystack problem. How do you identify as an individual the training that is going to meet your specific need? As a community, we're focusing a lot more on on-demand training now. And at EMBL-EBI, we've developed tutorial-based courses that people can access wherever they are and whenever they want to access them. We've also built up a very, very extensive catalogue of webinars. That said, face-to-face training is still a very, very important part of how we upskill people in bioinformatics, and I think it always will be. When EMBL-EBI first began its training programme about 12 years ago, I think we were still in didactic mode. We thought about what we knew and we tried to convey that to our audience. The way we do this has changed completely now. We think about what are the skills gaps that our trainees have and how can we best fill those. And this approach has gained a lot of traction in the bioinformatics training community as a whole now. But we still have a long way to go. And what I would like to see is that every learning opportunity is tagged in some way with the knowledge base and the skills and the behaviours that it's going to support an individual to develop. It's very easy to feel isolated as the only bioinformatics practitioner in a particular group or department or institute. And in the future, I would really like us to be helping to break down that isolation as much as we possibly can. Technology can really help with this. And so some of the tools that we've started to use are things like collaboration software and even, you know, simple things that we use on a day-to-day basis, such as Google Docs, which allow everybody to contribute collaboratively to a learning experience and then use that after a course has been completed. And we can get even cleverer with this in the case of specific individuals who can't attend a face-to-face event for whatever reason. In such cases, we now have a robot avatar that can act as the eyes and the ears of the individual who would otherwise have been there physically in the room. They're able to participate in paired work, they're able to participate in networking sessions, and they're even able to participate in coffee breaks and the discussions that are going on during those informal parts of the course. I think we're at a very exciting turning point in bioinformatics training. It's about the technology, but more than ever, it's about the people and how they build those collaborative communities going forward. We, as the bioinformatics training community, have supported the development of those skills to put us in a very good place going forward.